Back here at home, the ad interim appointment of Philippine Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno is approved at the committee level of the Commission on Appointments. This comes a day after no less than President Marcos quashed speculations about Diokno's rumored exit. Marcos earlier said he has assembled a great economic team and he does not see any reason for a reshuffle. Authorities investigating a new human trafficking scheme by a Chinese mafia that targets Filipinos. Senator Risa Ontiveros earlier revealed the syndicate has been recruiting Filipinos through fake ads, which promise them call center jobs in Thailand. They are then brought to Myanmar and forced into cryptocurrency investment scams. The Philippine Migrant Workers Department rescued a dozen Filipino victims in Myanmar over the weekend. But Secretary Susan Opless says one more person was left behind. She says they are physically and mentally traumatized.
They were made to work 14 hours nonstop. Yung iba kasi na who were there longer than the others, talagang na mental and trauma sila and may physical trauma din. Kasi there was this threat na once they fail to meet their quota, may physical abuse na dadanasin. Yung parusa would range from the use of an electric baton.
What, really?
Para kuryentehin sila.
May torture.
Oo. And 1,000 squats. Yun yung mga threat na, and sabi rin na madaling mawala kayo rito, walang makakaalam.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. honors Filipino scientists for their efforts in helping the country navigate the COVID-19 pandemic as he leads the opening of the National Science and Technology Week. Pia Gutierrez reports.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. assured Filipino scientists and researchers of the government's continued support for them as he again urged them to remain in the country and help establish a bigger pool of Filipino innovators. The president made a statement as he led the opening of the 2022 National Science and Technology Week here at the World Trade Center in Pasay City. In the speech, the president, who earlier admitted to being a frustrated scientist himself, lauded the skills and talents of Filipino scientists as he admired the new technologies presented by different agencies of the DOST at the exhibit here in the venue. He says the need to innovate has become more pronounced, especially as the country needs to survive in the future amid new challenges brought about by the COVID-19 pandemic, as well as the real threats posed by climate change. He added that hard science will continue to play a large part in coming up with these new solutions, and this just underscores the important role of scientists, researchers, and engineers. He also called on the Department of Science and Technology to invite local officials to come and see these available technologies as they may be applicable in providing solutions to the different problems of local communities.
We are facing a new world, very much a new world. COVID changed everything. And because it is a new world, these are new problems that we are facing. And therefore, we need to find new solutions. And innovation is the key. Innovation and agility. This celebration that we are doing of Science and Technology Week has taken on an added meaning because the innovations that will come, that we will need, a large part of that will be from pure science and technology.
The president added that as part of encouraging Filipinos, the government also plans to establish a scholarship program specifically for students of the STEM or the science, technology, engineering, and mathematics strand.
This will not be limited to those who have shown their capabilities, their ability, and how they deserve these scholarships here in the Philippines, but to any institution that they are accepted to abroad. So this is important so that we continue to develop our workforce, we continue to develop our capabilities and our knowledge. Lastly, I encourage our Filipino scientists researchers, inventors, and innovators. Continue sharing your expertise, especially to young people.
Meanwhile, a series of activities have been lined up here at the World Trade Center for the celebration of the 2022 National Science and Technology Week. And this includes not only this exhibit here at the World Trade Center, but also a number of seminars and workshops designed to promote science and technology innovations here in the Philippines.